coming up on the Met Report, we sit down with the cast of Spring Awakening to talk about their opening weekend here on campus.
And One Denver Church is picking up the pieces after Vandals tore through the century-old building.
It was a big weekend for MSU Denver athletics. See how volleyball and men and women's soccer prevailed. The Met Report starts now.
Thanks for joining us on the Met Report. I'm Yekta Eskandari.
And I'm Douglas Coulter. The tuition at MSU Denver is still among the most affordable in the state.
But that doesn't mean it's not on the rise. According to the Bursar's office tuition, the tuition has been increasing around 6% each year since 2013, from an average increase of 5% each year before. This year, however, tuition has took a 7% increase. The jump this year is attributed to the Metropolitan Bond Fee, which helped fund construction projects across campus, including the Tivoli Quad.
MSU Denver and UCD are teaming up to put on a Stop and Serve this Monday, benefiting the Children's Advocacy Center. The organization provides for the children and families affected by domestic abuse. More than half of the children served by the center are under the age of 6. Students that stop by will be decorating Halloween candy for the kids that will be visiting the center throughout the month. Roadrunners Give Back, Stop and Serve is based around the idea that everyone has 5 minutes to give.
With high-profile cases of sexual assault rising across the United States, it raises concerns right here on Auraria campus. I sat down with the campus police to discuss ways you can stay safe while on campus.
Of rape will serve no prison time.
So-called rape culture keeps coming up.
6 month sentence for sexually assaulting a young woman.
With the number of sexual assaults on college campuses rapidly increasing, how do we make sure to stay safe while on campus? We sat down with Chief of Police Michael Phibbs for tips on what precautions to take to keep Auraria safe.
So you can see the crimes against person on our campus are really low. For our population and our location and so forth, we are extremely safe. Happens occasionally, but not very often.
Sexual assault crimes are low on Auraria, but students and faculty need to know how to contact campus police in case of an emergency.
So easy ways to get a hold of us. All the orange towers that are on campus go directly to our dispatch center here at the police department, and those are monitored 24 hours a day, and we know where those phones are. So if you just get the button pushed, we know where they are, and officers will respond there right away.
Auraria also offers the Night Ride program that is available for anyone that feels uncomfortable while walking across campus at night. If you or someone you know is a victim of sexual assault, Auraria also has a place to talk.
The Phoenix Center deals specifically with interpersonal violence issues and can offer resources there. So there are a number of things that people can do if they don't feel safer.
Phibbs says the best tip is to be aware of your surroundings and not locked into your phone while walking on campus. For the Met Report, Alina Perry.
I'm Janelle Thompson with your weather forecast, but first we are going to go over your peak leaf viewing experience. So far for September, we've already seen a lot of these leaves drop off in the north, and as we push into October, we're going to go ahead and see some things from Colorado Springs all the way down to Pagosa Springs. Okay, so here's a guy who doesn't have a pumpkin spice latte. We have Toby the Burner. This puppy's out there in the aspen leaves just having some fun, getting out there and inviting you guys to go out as well. Currently, we are at 71 with a high of 77 for the day, and we have a little bit of cloud coverage and really light winds. For the rest of the day, it looks like we're going to trend right in the 70s, mid to high 70s, with a couple of clouds out there, and then there's a possibility for a little bit of rain, a potential, after 7 o'clock, and then pushing into 9 o'clock, it's going to get a little bit chillier out there for 64 degrees. The averages today is 72, a low of 42, which is not something we're ready for, I don't think, but our record high was at 90 in 1980, and September's average rainfall is at 1.0 inches. Coming up, we have a weekend forecast for you and talking about your fall-like weather and what we're looking for in the snow department.
All right, well, thank you, Janelle. The MSU Denver's latest musical opened up.
Avery Anderson is in the Rawls Theater with one of the cast members.
We're here in the Rawls Theater to talk about Spring Awakening with Maggie Angelo. So tell me a little bit about what Spring Awakening is.
Spring Awakening is actually the first musical of this season here at Metro. It's a show set in 1800s Germany about teenage angst, which isn't something that they would talk about in that time. There's lots of rock songs. It is a rock musical, so you're not going to be sitting around bored. We talk a lot about learning about our bodies and there's suicide talks and family tension talks. So it's definitely a heartfelt musical, but it's so much fun.
Yeah, a little bit raw, not your jazz hands musical. So what's your involvement with the show itself?
I play Ilsa. She's kind of the happy matriarch of the show. She comes up back up in the end and she's kind of just there saying, like, we all need to be happy and we just need to learn to love ourselves and love our own children and our parents and just be happy with where you are today.
Well, Spring Awakening opened last night for the Rawls Theater. Avery Anderson, The Met Report.
All right, thanks, Avery. Speaking of music, last year the music department at MSU Denver got their very own jazz band, and they are turning up the volume on the music scene on our area campus.
This Wednesday, MSU Big Band Jazz Ensemble held one of their concerts in King's Center. Metropolitan University Department of Music offers a variety of shows throughout the school year. MSU Jazz Ensemble is adding the cool factor to the program. The students who don't incline to perform in classical music can find their calling playing jazz.
We're doing so many wonderful genres. We're doing some jazz tunes, we're doing some salsa tunes, and we're going to be doing actually a couple of rap tunes.
The Department of Music at Metropolitan State University produces about 200 concerts a year. And many of those wonderful concerts are in regard to our new Jazz and American Improvised Music program that has been around for about a year. We've seen our first graduates. Last night's performance was directed by Don Byron. He is our newest full-time faculty member, jazz member, and he plays clarinet and saxophone and teaches lessons. And he also is the new director of our jazz ensemble.
The improvisation with genres and styles definitely makes our jazz ensemble worth seeing live. So if you do get that swing, be sure to check out Jazz Ensemble performing live at Auraria King Center. And as a bonus, it's free for students with a valid MSU ID.
Money can be tight during the school year, but there are a few jobs that work the best with students' busy schedules. Forbes magazine listed the top 10 best jobs for students. Some of the ones that made the list was a nanny or dog walker. They make on average $12 an hour. Bank tellers, restaurant hosts, office clerks, even massage therapists and hospital orderlies make decent hourly pay and will work around a school schedule. Most of these jobs only require a high school diploma as well. Students can also visit msudenver.edu and look on the Career Services site for links and resources to jobs in Denver.
The 8th annual Denver Beer Fest is underway this weekend, and our own local Tivoli Brewery makes the list of participating restaurants and breweries. Belen Ward has more.
MSU's Denver very own Tivoli Brewery will be entering the Great American Beer Festival.
The second time in a row. This year we're going to be pouring Tivoli Helles in part of the competition, as well as Siggy's Wild Horse Buck Beer, Jet Imperial Malt Liquor, Strawberry Mint Berliner Weiss, which is one of our original recipes, and then finally XXX Imperial IPA Export, which is really fun for us because we were able to introduce some of these older pre-prohibition style brands. The oldest brewery in Colorado is dating all the way back to 1859. And to be able to introduce these for the very first time to some people are being reintroduced, things like the Helles. They remember drinking this back in the 60s, Jet was back in the 50s, and to have these back available for people just for general consumption is a really big piece of our history and culture.
I am so excited when I'm on campus and I can have a nice, cold, refreshing beer.
Try the Hefeweizen and you'll be happy you did.
I
think I tried one of them a while back and liked it, and we decided to come in and try it here.
Denver brews more beer than any other American city. More than 200 beers are being served every day in Denver's tap houses, brew pubs, breweries, and gastro pubs. For the Met Report, Belen Ward.
All right, well, guys, awesome to see the Tivoli right here on campus represent.
Yeah, absolutely.
Indeed. Yes. Well, Chipotle has not had the best year.
And when we come back, the restaurant chain is taking their deliveries to new heights.
And in eMet, one man's trash is another man's art.
In Auraria, everything changes. There's always new things to see or do.
In your Noticiero de Met, we'll tell you all you need to know about our school.
News about our region and beyond our borders.
Every Friday morning at 10:30 through Comcast Channel 58 in Denver and on live stream in iTunes or Android. Noticiero de Met, the student voice of MSU Denver in Spanish.
Hey Roadrunners, my name is Mary Kate Newton, Editor-in-Chief of the Metropolitan, our school's weekly student-run newspaper, and this is what we do. Check us out for all the latest in Roadrunners sports, all the latest in entertainment and reviews, all the latest in MSU Denver news and other local happenings. And we are always looking for new writers, photographers, and copy editors, so if you're interested in being part of the staff, visit Tivoli 313. The Metropolitan is the student voice of MSU Denver. Let your voice be heard.
Tulsa officer Betty Shelby turned herself in after the shooting death of Terrence Crutcher. Shelby was booked in the Tulsa County Jail on charges of first-degree murder. Shelby says she shot Crutcher after he began reaching into the windows of his SUV, not following police commands. The arrest comes after Crutcher's family demanded a full investigation into the case. Shelby could face a minimum of 4 years in jail. And members of one of the oldest churches in Denver are cleaning up after vandals caused several thousands in damage. Officials at Sacred Heart Church believe the vandals showed up to an event at the church and hid inside. They shattered several windows and destroyed the Lady of Guadalupe statue, which is nearly a century old. A witness has a clear description of the vandal, but so far, police are still looking for a match.
You see some of this stained glass, and it's just something that can't be replaced. It is just something else, and that someone would do this, why? Only God knows.
Former leader of Israel, Shimon Peres, passed away this week. Peres suffered a massive stroke 2 weeks ago, and he took a turn for the worse. Earlier this week, Peres received a Peace Prize in 1994 after he became instrumental in signing the peace treaty between Israel and Palestine. Friends and family of Miami Marlins pitcher Jose Fernandez are mourning after the young athlete passed away following a boating accident on Sunday. The team showed their support for Fernandez at a game on Monday by wearing his number 16 and last name on their jerseys. Marlins player D. Gordon switched to batting right-handed on his third pitch, as Fernandez did. The switch resulted in his first home run of the season, and at the end of the game, the team circled around the pitcher's mound, leaving their hats to honor Fernandez. A week prior to the accident, Fernandez announced that he and his girlfriend were expecting their first child. According to the FBI's annual crime report released this week, the incidents of violent crime are on the rise. The report shows close to 16,000 murders and 90,000 rapes across the nation in 2015. Meanwhile, property crimes are on the decrease despite $390 million in property losses from crime.
An international crime report released this week concludes that Malaysian Flight 17, shot down in 2014, was carried out by pro-Russian forces. The report was led by Dutch officials and confirms the wreck that killed 298 people was taken down by a missile. Investigators have identified 100 people they would like to speak with who they believe were involved in transporting or using the missile launcher. Well, it's been a rough year for Chipotle, but a new method of delivery might help them bounce back. Chipotle is teaming up with Google Drone to test a new delivery option for students at Virginia Tech. The students will be able to order Chipotle from a kiosk on campus and have it delivered to them from a local store. The drone testing is part of a bigger mission to see how efficient a drone can be dropping supplies during natural disasters.
It is an end of an era for the BlackBerry. While it used to be the hottest phone among the business elite, celebrities, and politicians, it has now become one of the least sold phones to date. BlackBerry has decided to end manufacturing of the phone due to latest trend of smartphones. Similar full keyboard phones will still be continued to be made by smaller phone manufacturers. Though the new iPhone 7 has some sleek designs and new features, there is one component that people are not so happy about. Apple's latest release has broken some music lovers' hearts when they reveal that there will be no headphone jack. The company believes that wireless is the feature and now requiring customers to buy the new AirPods, their version of wireless headphones. However, users are not going for this. Instead, the internet is finding ways to go around this new feature. One YouTuber suggests that there is a hidden headphone jack if you drill into the iPhone. This has prompted some people to actually try this and instead ruin their phones.
All right, well, check this out. Turkish company LetVision, which brought Transformers into real life. The car known as Electrons is a BMW that can transform into a transformer robot. The company said it took 12 engineers and 4 technicians 8 months to make this model happen. The remote-controlled car cannot be driven, but it does have an arm and hand movements as well as head motions. There has been no price set, but the transformer is expected to be sold in the near future. I don't see that being in my price range, even though they haven't released it yet. I'm sure I won't be able to afford that for a while.
Neither can I.
All right, well, thank you. Making the decision to join the armed forces is the first step to a big change. Miranda McCotchkins joins us now to show us what first few days are like of basic training.
They told me that lots of people have misconceptions about the Army, so I went along with some teachers on an Army educator tour to learn more.
Yes, sir, Sergeant.
It's day one for new basic trainees on Fort Sill. The first few days will be spent in this building, getting their Army file started and transforming them from civilians to soldiers. First, they fill out all required paperwork.
This is where we develop their life insurance, their pay. We set up their bank accounts here, and their family members are enrolled into the United States Army system.
Then their transformation begins with a haircut. All men must get their heads buzzed or shaved. They do this for cleanliness and also to look unified.
Looks good, bud.
And women's hair must be cut short or pinned back. Next, they get fitted for their Army combat uniform and their dress uniform.
Come pick up their bags, they get their shoes, they get their shorts. Every equipment is accounted for.
Everything is measured out to fit perfectly. Especially their boots, which could cause injury during basic training if not fitted properly. They also receive duffel bags to hold all their gear. Once they have their combat uniform on, they get their official picture taken for their ID.
We'll go ahead and take their picture right here. That's your history shot. Most important picture you'll ever take.
If they only knew the value of the picture, they don't think about it. Oh, it's going to cost me $25. Remember, that picture's that's the only one shot you have.
These soldiers are now ready to begin the 9-week basic training period.
Over the next couple of weeks, the trainees will learn tactical and survival skills, as well as learning about basic Army life and military customs. And it was just a really cool experience overall. It was actually the first time that they met the drill sergeant, so that was a little intense. There was a lot of yelling going on.
Interesting experience, but you made it back.
I did. I survived, so.
We're glad you're safe.
Yeah. Thanks, Miranda.
Tomorrow morning it's 62 degrees with a lot of sunshine, and the winds are right around 5 to 10 miles per hour. So it's a little chilly, but later on in the afternoon we'll be warming up to 79 degrees, and we'll have a little bit of cloud coverage for Saturday. However, we are looking up in Brighton, Thornton, and Denver area, all in the 70s. Of course, Brighton's a little bit warmer. Evergreen and Conifer on Saturday are going to be a little bit chillier, however, and that is pretty much the standard for the whole weekend, because Sunday looks identical to Saturday, and with that kind of chillier up in the mountains, I am dressed in all black because we are mourning the death of our summer and welcoming formally the winter because of this cold front starting in Seattle. It's just a little bit of precipitation, and we have like a high pressure system that is leaving some snow flurries up in the mountains for the weekend, especially on Saturday. Chicago's got this stormy weather and a cold front that's also affecting Florida. On Sunday, we have a cold front with that low pressure system, which, like I said earlier, is just got some storms and rain for us, but very dry through the middle of this country. And Denver will be very dry, and then we'll have a little bit of a storm up in the north, and it's hitting down in Florida as well. As far as Monday through Friday, we are looking at 81 degrees for Monday. Cloud coverage through on to Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday are bright and sunny at 70 and 73 for that week. All right, guys, take a look at some of the leaves up in the mountains already starting to change. I got this video up around the Gore Range, and the view is absolutely stunning. If you are headed up to the high country to get a glimpse of the fall colors, this weekend is the perfect weekend to do so. But hurry up there because time is running out. We will be right back.
Colorado's weather is always changing.
We're student meteorologists trained to keep you safe.
We have the latest weekend forecast and help you prepare for the week ahead.
You can watch our weather forecast on Facebook, Twitter, MyMetMedia.com, and on TV.
We help you stay weather aware.
The Met Sports Show is the longest tenured program on Met Radio. Having won the SPGA Region 9 Mark of Excellence Award three times since 2013, the Sports Show serves as the model program for new employees and volunteers to learn from and shadow.
Divinely, dangerously, decadent. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to Roundabout Theater Company's Tony Award-winning Cabaret.
Plays the Buell Theater September 27th through October 9th. Tickets at denvercenter.org or call 303-893-4100.
Hey guys, TGI Friday. I'm Vinny Thomas here with eMet, and I'm thrilled to share with you this new exhibit at the Denver Zoo, but first, we need a snappy new accessory. Now, by now, we should all know that Snapchat Inc. is going by a new name. Seriously, guys, it's just called Snap. But you might not know that they're about to release a brand new product. Watch out, GoPro. Snap Spectacles are Snap's newest technological innovation. These stylish sunglasses sport a small camera lens, which allows users to record 10-second videos. Snap Spectacles will, of course, sync with the Snapchat app. No word yet on whether our favorite filters will be integrated. I don't know, seems kind of like Cold War spy equipment to me. And it's the weekend, finally we have time to see some of our favorite new must-sees. Of course, Tim Burton's newest movie looks creepy. No surprise there, I'm calling it now, mascara is going to be everywhere. Based on the best-selling novel, moviegoers are taken to a mysterious orphanage populated by children with extraordinary powers. Sam Jackson, Judi Dench, and Chris O'Dowd all make an appearance in Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children. This epic movie recounts the tragic events of the 2010 oil spill, which decimated the economy and environment in the Gulf of Mexico. Deepwater Horizon seems like a typical Hollywood disaster film, filled with explosions and thrills. Marky Mark plays Mike Williams, who was actually present during the explosion. Critics think that the film could just be another exploitation of an American tragedy, but you be the judge. All right, those look great, and there's garbage all over the Denver Zoo, but in a good way.
The Washed Ashore Art to Save the Sea exhibition is making beauty from a bad situation. A stroll across zoo grounds reveals a number of hidden gems, a kaleidoscopic parrotfish, an anemone garden, and even a leaping marlin. Take a closer look, though, and you'll notice something that makes these sculptures look even more incredible. From flip-flops to fishing line, these massive artworks are made of trash. Zoo visitors are certainly enjoying the temporary additions.
I wasn't sure what really to expect, but I was really surprised with everything.
Guests also appreciate the message that the pieces convey. Vibrant marine life sculpted from the very material which threatens their existence.
It makes you kind of sad at the end to realize that something like this could have been made out of all this trash.
Standing behind me here is Priscilla, the parrotfish, my new friend. She's absolutely massive. She stands about 8 feet tall and she's about 15 feet long. Each sculpture here at the zoo was designed and directed by a professional artist and then assembled through a collaboration of Washed Ashore volunteers, team members, and students in Oregon. Since their foundation in 2010, Washed Ashore estimates it has processed more than 38,000 pounds of marine debris and assembled over 60 sculptures, which tour the nation. One thing's for sure, the sculptures here at the Denver Zoo are certainly making a splash.
All right, thanks for watching EMET. Stick around for sports with Luna.
It could have been like this all the time, but life got in the way. See the Tennessee Williams masterpiece, The Glass Menagerie, at the Denver Center, September 9th through October 16th.
Oh, hello there. I'm Avery Anderson, host of the Nightly Met here on Channel 58. Do you like watching television that's witty and funny? Maybe you enjoy seeing local performers being highlighted, or you like to watch fun interviews with local citizens. If that's the case, then don't watch our show. We're just college kids, so the jokes are only funny some of the time. The bands suck, and the interviews are awkward to watch. But if that sounds good to you, make sure you tune in every Friday night at 7 p.m. or go to mymetmedia.com.
MyMetMedia.com is a new interactive website. Watch full newscasts from the Met Report. The Metropolitan have you covered. KMET Radio have everything you need 24 hours a day. El Noticiero TV Met give you news in Spanish. How to advertise with us? Email sales@metmedia.com.
Hey everyone, Luna Nas here with your Roadrunner Sport Update. Let's jump right into it. The Lady Roadrunners are on a hot streak, winning four in a row and remain undefeated in the RMAC as they faced Fort Lewis last Saturday. The ladies were all business and cruised to a 3-0 win over the Skyhawks. The big stars of the weekend, Brandy Tor with 13 assists and Michaela Smith with 7 kills and 6 digs in the first set, winning 27-25. The Skyhawks started the second set strong, but MSU Denver overcame the slow start to win 25-18. The Roadrunners just cannot be handled by Fort Lewis as the dominance continued in the third set, winning 25-19. Tor had herself a day, finishing with 39 assists and 13 digs, make that 5 straight for Roadrunner volleyball. Speaking of dominant performances, men's soccer goes off for an offensive explosion against Colorado Christian, seeking their first RMAC road victory. The Roadrunners get off to a great start with Dylan Wood scoring in the 9th minute, netting his first goal of the season. And now, this is where the fun begins. You get a goal, you get a goal, everybody gets a goal. Seniors Jeff Gillis and Josh Belfridge both score on penalty kicks, while senior Dustin Burge and sophomore Jaden Moreschini also get into the action, scoring a goal each, sealing the deal 5-1. The fellas are gonna be pretty hard to stop if they keep scoring like that. The ladies, however, got off to a bit of a shaky start, but look to turn things around here at home. They take on Adams State University last Friday, hoping for their first win in conference play. Raina Banks got things started early with a shot on goal, missing just wide right. Banks again, this time with a pretty give and go to Sherstein Sharp, but good save there by Adams State goalie by Adams State goalkeeper. Banks had a total of 6 shots on goal. Senior Elise Bonard puts MSU Denver on the board with a goal off the rebound from sophomore Reagan Steed. Adams State had a chance to tie the game later on the 70th minute with Maggie Carrico taking 2 shots back-to-back. But MSU Denver holds on for the 1-0 victory.
It was good. I think for us, we've been lacking a little bit of confidence. We've had some tough games on the road. So to get the win at home, obviously we're happy to be back on the winning side of things.
Yeah, so all W's last weekend across the board. Hopefully that momentum carries on to this weekend.
Can't wait to watch.
Awesome. Yeah, hopefully we keep those W's coming as well. Thanks, Luna. That's all the time we have for now. For all the latest campus news throughout the week, be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And you can always visit our website at mymetmedia.com. Thanks for watching.